Now that we've added the CMSS and repeaters to radio management, we can begin setting them up. Remember that we're using radio management in configuration mode here, which means that there aren't code plugs, but rather configurations and sets. What you see here only needs to be done once, when the system is set up. Adding radios and repeaters becomes really easy after that, since most of the configuration work is done, and all you need to do is to apply this to the new radio or repeater. So the first thing I'm going to do is to set up the Capacity Max system server. And to do that, I need to click on Manage Configuration and then Add a Configuration. The configuration that I need to select here is a Capacity Max system server, and then I need to click OK. What this does is that it creates a configuration for the CMSS. Now we need to give a name for this configuration, something that we can easily remember. So I'm going to call this CMSS config 1. The name is up to you. You can add some comments, then you need to click on Save. Now, if you click Close or click away from the current page, Radio Management will prompt you to save. There are some other settings here. The first one of these is Systems, and you'll see that it's red. The reason why is that there is no system set, so I need to click on Add. When I click on Add, it creates a default system set, and I need to now go through and change some settings. The first thing I want to do is to give it a memorable name. I'm not going to go into every single setting, so here is a summary of what you need to change here. You generally don't need to go through everything, so only these settings that you see here are the ones which are, in my opinion, important. One of the things I need to do is to go to the site selection and define which site set is to be used here. And when I click on that, you'll see that there's nothing. This means that I need to click on Add. So there are some parameters that I need to add here. The first one of these is to click on Add Sites. And now it asks me to select a system. So I select a system that I've just created. Now I need to add sites to the system. And when I click on plus, you will see that it's blank and there is nothing else to select. The reason why is that I need to go back to Manage and then to Sets, and I need to go to the Capacity Max system set and add the sites here. So you can see that there is already a site that has some default information in it, and I need to go through and change these things now. Once again, you don't need to change every single thing here. So here is a summary of the important settings. If you're following along, now is a good time to press pause. One of the things you would need to do when you create sites is to add channels and a channel plan. In my case here, when I added the CMSS, it created a default channel plan which was UHF. So I need to remove this and replace it with the VHF channel plan because the repeaters in the system are VHF. I can go through and enter some parameters for the site. So the first thing you need to do is to give the set a name, and then you need to specify the channels. So here we have what is known as the base frequency, the range of channel numbers, and a duplex split. This is used when you have a fixed or standard channel plan. Then there is also the possibility to add flexible channels, and you would use these if the TX and RX frequencies did not have the same duplex split. So once I've entered this information, I can click Save. Now, because I've already created a CMSS config, any changes I make to the set means that the config must be updated. So this is why you'll see this message. All I have to do here is click OK. These settings are not that important, but I'm just going through to check everything is okay. Now I'm going to go look back at the config, and you'll see the site is there. Now let's set up the repeaters. I need to go to Manage, Configurations, and select the repeater I want to set up. And then I go to the capacity max systems and choose capacity max features. And here I right button click and select an existing set because I've already created this when I done the CMSS. So that is all that I need to do here. Then I need to go to the zone and into the personality. You might see nothing here, or you might see non-capacity max channels. If that is the case, you'll need to add one capacity max personality. Here, I can just give it a name to remember, and then I need to select what system this repeater is a part of. So that would be the system set that I created earlier. Then I need to select the site this repeater is on, as well as the channel the repeater will be using. All the settings you see here will have already been defined, as this was done when I set up the CMSS. One thing you may want to change is the power level. In my case, it's low power because, well, it's just a demo system and we don't want to be putting out full power here. The other parameters are not important because they all relate to IP site connect and capacity plus operation. And of course, we won't be using it here. Then I need to repeat the same exercise again on the second repeater, and it's pretty much the same, except we use a different channel. One thing you need to be careful of is the device IDs of the repeaters. This must be unique within a site, as it defines the repeater's IP address. To do that, go to System View at the top right. The device ID can be 1 through 15. You can reuse the same device IDs on other sites, just the device ID must not be duplicated on a site. At the same time, you should also make the radio ID unique, though having a unique device ID is, in my opinion, more important. Now we can do some basic checks. One of these is to make sure that we have connectivity with the CMSS. So in a web browser, we would type in the IP address of the trunking controller, and if it's running, it will bring up this page. Next, we can check the Ethernet switch by entering its IP address. And if you click on Continue, you can see some information about what is connected to the switch and so forth. Next, you can enter the IP addresses of the repeaters. Now, when the repeaters are running in a Capacity Max system, they have a web page and it shows some status information. This tells you that everything is connected and up and running. Next, we'll set up the radio.